Then punches up. When I shout break, you break clean. And remember, defend yourselves at all times. Shake hands.
And so, a fight that has been anticipated here in Scotland for a while. A chance for Josh Taylor to take a step up against that man, Victor Posto, a former champion who wants another chance at a world title. The excitement is palpable in this arena, and it is now begun. Round number one, scheduled for 12.
Both guys look in fantastic shape at the start, Al, don't they?
Yeah, they're ready for this fight. There's no question about that. Postal and Taylor, almost the same height, and normally Postal has a height advantage over fighters at 140 pounds.
Both guys very, very tall for 140.
Taylor, of course, a boxer puncher who can walk fighters down. Postal coming forward himself, a little bit of a surprise early in this fight.
Maybe trying to stamp his authority nice and early.
Postal has a good jab and a good right hand, which he hopes to use here tonight against the left-hander. He landed that right hand many times when he won his title back in 2015 against Lucas Matisse. Wild left hand by Taylor. Postal being aggressive here in round number one and trying to push the pace.
Are you surprised at that, Al, that Postal's been so aggressive? Yeah.
I thought he would box earlier, didn't you?
Yeah, I did, actually, to be honest. And I mean, he knows that Taylor is a noted puncher, but I think that he's maybe using his experience here to try and take away Taylor's confidence early.
We'll see. A good first round, and Postal rips the right hand, and yet another one. So far, Josh Taylor has yet to get his offense started here in round one, and we are halfway through the round.
Head clash, good left hand from Taylor, but a head clash prior to that left hand.
Often the case with righties and lefties,
yeah.
Of course.
No cuts though.
Yeah, thank goodness. A little over a minute left to go in round number one. In his last fight, Taylor beat Winston Campos, knocked him out in three rounds. Good body work by
Postal. Great body shot from Postal.
So Victor Postal has had himself what I think he envisioned as the perfect round one, at least to this point.
He looks calm and composed, doesn't he? You can see that experience that Postal has.
And the crowd here trying to rally Josh Taylor. It's very early in this fight, of course. But Victor Postal has certainly had himself a good first round. Taylor, the 27-year-old, with only 12 fights, taking a quantum leap up in competition. Postal with a nice combination there, but one of those punches got through. So as we come to the end of round number one, it is a round that Victor Postal will put in his column, perhaps. He fought very well in round one.
Yep.
Well, look back at some of the action from the last round. There's the clash of heads that we saw from Taylor and Postal, and luckily, no cuts from them.
Very luckily. You know, that was quite a heavy collision. That's that great body shot out from Postal, set up with the jab. Josh Taylor really did feel that shot. You can see him just taking a step back there and regrouping.
Just get the straight shots off. Yeah. And reach me a jab, you're pouring it, OK? Reach it. OK? 20 seconds, keep it in the center, stop backing off. Okay, keep it in the center, you need space to drop back. Okay, 15. And as soon as you drop back once, move your head. You went 2-3 times, got there with the right hook.
Yeah.
Okay, back once, and take it, slip in. Okay,
round two.
So we move into round two. Josh Taylor, the 2012 Olympian. From Scotland and from the Ukraine, Victor Postal, 34-year-old former champion. And Taylor gets off with a good left hand there. Taylor trying to close the distance on Postal. Now there's the body work from Taylor, and both he and Barry McGuigan and Shane McGuigan said that's important, and a good left hand by Taylor. So he has picked up the pace here in round number two.
Yeah, this is where Josh Taylor wants to be, using his physical strength, his youth, his endurance. He wants to rough Postal up, take him out his stride. He doesn't want him boxing here at long range. Great right hook from Josh Taylor. Really found his ground really quite quickly, Al, in this second round.
Different demeanor entirely, and a nice jab a moment ago, and then the straight left hand by Taylor. And Postal tries to respond with some shots on the inside.
Still looks cool and calm.
Taylor doubling with the jab as kind of a range finder, and then switches back to righty, which he can do and has on many occasions in his pro career. Good body shot by Postal.
Good start to round two by Josh Taylor. Trying to keep his right foot outside Postal's left foot. Jab over that jab.
Important for a left-hander, and Taylor has used the jab much more effectively here in this round. We're more than halfway through the round, and Taylor has come back from a difficult first round to control it here, but here comes Victor Postal trying to land the jab in the straight right hand. We mentioned Postal with so much more experience than Taylor, but Josh Taylor is not the typical 12-fight fighter.
That's certainly
sure.
Not. He's got a great variety of punches.
Good body work there by Taylor. And now he's starting to get into a position where he can throw some body punches, as we're under a minute left to go here in round number two.
You know, for a tall lefty, he's brilliant up close. He's very, very good up close. And if he can take the fight to close distance, I don't reckon Postal has much of a chance. While he's at long range and they're boxing technically and sharp early on, Postal looks really, really good.
Nice left hand a moment ago by Josh Taylor.
Countering each other's counters.
Both men using jab, and there is a cut over the right eye of Victor Postal. Whether it came from a clash of heads remains to be seen. We'll attempt to find that out, but some drama now as we end round number two. Barry McGuigan looking on, liking what he saw in round two better, I'm sure. And here, maybe we'll get a look to see if where that cut might have happened. There they bang heads. I don't know if that created the cut.
Yeah, really difficult to tell where that cut came from.
It's going to be very difficult to tell. Now we'll take another look and let's see what happens here. But Taylor landing a nice right hook a moment ago in what was a much better round for him. Taylor switched righty during a portion of the round and was effective. Now that's where the clash of heads created
the cut.
Yep. Now the question is, has the referee ruled it a clash of heads? If he has, this fight has to go four full rounds for them to go to the scorecard.
Ah, right. Okay. If it ends, WBC rules, yeah.
If it ends before that, it would be a no contest if it's a result of the cut. You are welcome, sir. We're in round number three of this scheduled 12-round. Al Bernstein, along with Alex Arthur, Nick Holling, and all our Channel 5 compatriots, as we bring you a much-anticipated matchup. Victor Postal on the left of your screen, taking on Josh Taylor. A cut over the right eye of Postal that we believe came from a clash of heads. So far, they're containing that punch, that cut rather, has not bled more. And the crowd getting behind Taylor. Postal pecking away with the right hand and the left hook.
He's not putting much weight behind those shots, is he? I think, is he judging distance? Is he just actually testing and the water just to see, to feel if he can actually get the big shots off?
Yeah, it's possible, and he's a very cagey veteran. Taylor
very experienced as well, so.
And a warning from Ian John Lewis to Taylor for some of the roughhouse tactics on the inside. Taylor has done a good job of kind of bullying Postal when he's been on the inside.
Both training great shots there.
But Postal took that left hand very well.
Yeah.
And Postal now working behind the jab as he did in round one. Halfway through this third round.
You don't want Postal to get comfortable. You don't want him to settle. Josh Taylor really wants to keep him uneasy and guessing all the time and trying to make him feel like he's away from home and he's having a rough night, you know. But right now, that's not happening now.
Well, round one was a good one for Postal. Round two seemed like it was a good one for Taylor. And here in round three, the distance has favored Postal a bit, although Taylor has landed some very good shots. So this is a close round. And again, the heads keep coming together, and Postal's able to sneak in a right hand. Ian John Lewis is going to earn his money tonight. This could be a tough match to referee.
Yeah.
Good body work downstairs by Taylor.
Josh Taylor's a great body puncher. We might not see that coming to play until later on in the fight, though, Al.
I agree.
When both guys start to settle their feet a little bit.
Taylor cutting off the ring and landing a big left hand. So a very good round three. Good action and a very close round, and Postal goes downstairs. So this fight is turning into a very interesting affair. And round number three fades into the night.
Keep moving your head, don't give him them first two shots.
Look back at the last round. Postal, the jab and a straight right hand, but a good counter punch.
Of course, both guys trading big shots, power shots, backhand shots, trying to out-punch each other. But at this stage, I think they're still trying to feel each other out. They've not totally engaged yet. And I think that when that does happen, we're going to see fireworks.
And round three was the most exciting round of the fight, to be sure.
By
jab,
far.
Then work your way. Stop looking for big shots. Yeah. All right, put the last shot in hard, okay? Slip and slide, mate. 15. Try and do hard. Put it on. Keep backing them up. Your hands up wide. Move your fucking head. Roll, slip, slide. Every time you've got to change your attack, okay? And then jab off it and then work.
Headed to round number four. So far, a very close fight. Round three, perhaps the most competitive and interesting of the fights. Taylor is the third straight left-hander that Postal has faced. And so far, Postal's had some good moments. A slip there, not a knockdown. Shane McGuigan urging Taylor to use his jab, and he came out in this round doing it.
And also, gentlemen, move the head after he throws a combination just to roll out of the shots rather than hold his feet and keep his head in a stationary position. And I can see exactly where Shane McGuigan's coming from when he says that, but it's kind of difficult against a guy with Postal's stature and solid jab. And, you know, he's a real steady guy. He's never been off his feet once, really.
Taylor working on the inside, working on the body, Postal holding, but then Taylor's able to sneak in one more right hand downstairs. And the Taylor jab now starting to get moving.
If you had to say anyone was looking particularly uncomfortable at this point, I would say it's Postal, to be honest, because he's been roughed up a little bit more than he's probably used to this point in his, well, you'd say his career. He's experienced almost everything. But at this point, I think if anyone's feathers were ruffled, I would say it was Postal's.
Well, we'll see. He's fighting at range during this round, and that's helping him a bit. We're halfway through round number four. Taylor attacking, trying to get Postal against the ropes. This fight has been fought mostly in the center of the ring, and Postal landing a big right hand. Nice counter left hook.
Huge counter
Taylor.
Shot. Oh, and good combination to come back for Postal. Beautiful lead left uppercut, followed by a right hand.
So the action continues here in round number four, much like it did in round three. This fight is being fought at a very high level.
Yeah, both guys are technically brilliant, really, aren't they? Both.
Two of the top 140 pounders in the world in the WBC. They are ranked number one and number two.
Double right hand from Pistol. Pistol looking really busy here. Landing some good, straight, neat shots.
With under a half minute left to go. Both men doing good work in this round. And Pistol ripping another right hand to the body. And his jab has
beautiful
worked
jab.
Overtime.
Beautiful jab.
They are fighting. They hope for a chance to face Jose Ramirez, who has one more defense, optional defense, and whoever wins this fight would be the mandatory. And right now, it's up for grabs. In the last round, great exchanges. Taylor is a right-hander. Gets hit with a big body punch, but shows the good countering ability with the left hook.
There's that nice lead left uppercut from Pistol. Josh slightly lent his weight onto his like right leg, and Pistol seized the opportunity and chipped in that nice left uppercut. Technically, he's brilliant. He sees little things that other people wouldn't see in the ring, and you know, that's experience, Al.
Second turn, round five.
This 140 pound title eliminator match between Josh Taylor on the left of your screen and Victor Pistol, the former champion, on the right, has been a scrappy affair, well fought, and very interesting and very close. We are headed into the fifth round. Nobody's been down. There was a cut over the right eye of Pistol that we thought came from a clash of heads. It has not reopened since. Taylor trying to go downstairs. This fight has been fought at range sometimes, and then sometimes Taylor has been able to get on the inside.
Yeah, the distances have been mainly long range and middle distance. There's not been a lot of close fighting. If it does go close and both guys decide to put their heads on each other's chest or touch foreheads, there's only one winner, and it's Josh Taylor. He's brilliant up close.
Yeah, well, he's got to get there.
He's got to get there, Al. Exactly, yeah, exactly.
Pistol, of course, a veteran, has controlled the distance. The other thing Victor Pistol has done in this fight is throw a right hand to the body that has been very effective. Now here comes Taylor back again.
It's kind of like an uppercut. It's not an uppercut, it's not a hook, it's like a scooping shot that goes right underneath Josh Taylor's left elbow. It's a really effective shot. He normally throws it behind the jab as well, yeah.
Taylor landing a left hand just a moment ago as we reach the halfway mark here in round number five. In what has been a very competitive 140-pound fight. Pistol in the last round or so has worked distance very well and kept Taylor on the end of his jab and a straight right hand. Taylor in his 13th professional fight only, taking on a former champion and a fighter who we now know, based on these five rounds, is not damaged good. At 34, he's still a very good fighter.
He's looking very, very good.
Good body work again by Pistol. At this juncture in the fight, we would have thought Taylor would have done more body work, but Postal's been able to do it from the outside.
See, he just controls the range and the distance out with his left hand. If Taylor presses the action, Pistol will move back with an extended left hand. He keeps Josh Taylor, or tries to keep Josh Taylor, at distance all the time.
Pistol using a lot of this ring, and it's a pretty large ring. Taylor trying to get on the inside, but taking a right hand, and now Taylor switches to the right hand stance. Pistol has been down in his last two fights, twice against Crawford and once in his last fight, but not so far tonight.
Everything you do is
some touches. Okay?
Head forwards, mate.
That was much better, okay? Nice and quick.
Cross that end again.
You've got to pick the pace up,
isn't he? Right, he's hitting two shots. He's hitting him a couple of good shots. He's just pick. Okay, you've got to just stay on the whole time. Once you hit him a couple of hard shots, back on the touches, just keep peppering him. Okay? Keep in the centre.
That's an awkward job.
You're giving way too much space. You've got to feint, push him back, attack when he's closer to the ropes, okay? And then start driving him downstairs.
Yeah.
Okay?
You've got the fitness to be on it.
Shane McGuigan urging Josh Taylor to take the fight to close distance, and he knows that that's where he's most effective.
All right, stop slipping and sliding. Just keep nice and neat, okay?
Concentration,
come on, Josh.
We're headed toward the halfway mark of this 140-pound fight. It has been a very interesting one and well fought. And as Alex pointed out, Shane McGuigan wants Taylor to pick up the pace and close the distance against Victor Postol. He'll need to do that, I think. Sweeping right hand misses by Taylor. There's where Taylor wants to work. Postol trying to hold. Good body shot again by Victor Postol. Taylor going downstairs with his right hand. That has been one of the rare body punches we've seen from Taylor. And the Taylor jab. Postol wanting to be broken by referee Lewis, but he said, no, you guys can fight on. Just about halfway through round number six, and again, the fight is continuing to be fought at long range.
Postol just chipping away, really, isn't he? Not unloading with anything heavy, just keeps chipping away, just making sure that he's, like, touching Josh all the time.
Yeah, he's keeping Taylor at distance right now.
Yeah.
And then when Taylor does get in the side, he's holding, and will and referee Lewis is giving them a chance to fight on the inside, which is a
problem. Oh, good shot right up again from Josh Taylor up close.
And a nice right hook by Taylor. Did he stun?
Yes, I think he did. I think that's the first time I've seen Postol visibly hook.
And a good body shot by Josh Taylor. So he has picked up the pace here.
You know, I don't think he's hooked to the point that, you know, he needs to put his foot on the gas. I think he was just stunned relatively.
Well, Taylor's sensing that there's an opportunity for him, and he is moving forward here with under a minute left to go here in round number six. Taylor with a sweeping left hook. Now fighting out of the right-handed stance. And he is just coming forward, trying to bully Victor Postol.
Good tactics from Josh Taylor now. And about the right time in the fight for him to actually pick up the tempo a little bit. Got to get that old guy feeling tired and weak. And
nice jab by Taylor. And in the last minute of this round, he has probably taken this round.
Yeah.
A round in which Postol originally was controlling things. So the final seconds of round six, it has been a good round, at least the last half of it, for Josh Taylor. And he and his fans will head into round seven with a little bit of renewed confidence. Let's go to Andy Clark, who has a special guest.
George, down here watching your teammate, Josh Taylor. How have you got it?
I've got Taylor ahead. It's a real close fight. A few rounds could go either way. That last round was a good round from Taylor. He's starting to stamp his authority. I think he's starting to hopefully break Postol's heart. It's a frantic pace. It's who wants it most at the moment. Taylor, when he's in the south position, he's getting great work off, lands a couple of telling body shots that round, and I think that's going to be hopefully now the momentum swinging in his way.
It's high quality stuff. You've been boxing at this level for a long time. They cannot afford to make mistakes.
No, he's only had 12 fights, Taylor, so he's had to learn quick. He's got the talent, he's got the skills. Has he now got the experience? I believe he does, but it's going to be a great learning fight for him. I'm sure he'll go on to win. We will.
So some expert commentary from George Groves, certainly a man that knows his way around a boxing ring. And we are into round number 7. And that's how Alex has this fight scored right now. Taylor with a slight edge. And it's certainly a close fight. Body shot by Josh Taylor.
Straight slightly low, maybe even. I like this right hook that Josh Taylor's throwing. He slightly skips to the right and throws a right hook over Pistol's jab. It's absolutely brilliant shot. Very effective punch.
Josh Taylor has picked up the pace in the last 3 minutes or 4 minutes of this fight. There's no question about that. He is working the body, and he is switching back and forth to righty and lefty very effectively. It's round 7, scheduled for 12, and a thunderous left hand by Josh Taylor. Taylor working the jab, and again, there he switches to right-handed. And Postal lands a very nice jab.
There's that shot again, Al, that scooping right hand over the top. I actually spoke to my brother Mark about this earlier, about that shot. Josh Taylor uses it very effectively. He moves to the right, he puts his right foot outside his opponent's left leg, and he throws the right hook over the top. Tremendous shot when he lands it.
Halfway through round number 7 in this 12-rounder. Short little uppercut that just missed by Postal. In a round in which Taylor has been effective in pushing forward, and Postal now trying to take the advantage back. Nice short left hook to the inside, and a right by Postal.
Oh, Postal looking strong. Good combinations he put together there. Josh may be slightly riled for the first time.
Nice right hand, and a warning justifiably so for using the shoulder by Victor Postal. He was a little annoyed at the roughhouse tactics by Taylor. Postal pushing Taylor back.
I think Josh might have a little nick over his right eye as well. A little slight nick over his right eye with that left hook that landed earlier.
Huge right hand by Postal. Taylor is holding on.
Yep.
We'll see if he's hurt. And there is a nick over the right eye. Another right hand by Postal.
Followed by a good stiff left jab behind it.
With a half minute left to go in round 7, Josh Taylor needs to get through the 7th. But he is attacking. Not apparently worried about walking into another one of those right hands. Seconds remaining here in round number 7. And Taylor trying to take back the advantage in this round.
He's experiencing things he's never experienced here before.
He has been taken into deep waters in this round by Victor Postal. We'll see how it all plays out as we head to round number 8.
Stay tight, move around, okay?
All right?
When he's forcing it, this is when you're going to get your moments, okay?
Josh Taylor coming early on in the round, landing some very good shots. The beginning part of that round was very effective, but things like that uppercut and that left hook by Postal and then a huge right hand stunned Josh Taylor, and the round turned, and there is a cut over the right eye.
Over the right eye, yeah.
Josh Taylor.
I don't know quite how that cut came about. I think it was maybe a left hook over the top of Taylor's right jab.
Don't let him back in the fight. That jab going. Fiddle him about with a jab.
You've got the fitness to do this all night. Come on,
Everything
believe
nice
in yourself.
Quick, nice and fast. Don't look for power.
Round 8 may be the most important professional round for Josh Taylor. He has been taken into a territory he's not seen before with Victor Postal in the last round. He was stunned. Postal kept up the attack. Let's see if Taylor can come back here in this 8th round. Postal, the 34-year-old from the Ukraine, coming in here to Taylor's home area, trying to leave with a victory. It would give him a world title shot, and for Josh Taylor, just the same. He wants that win to get a shot at Ramirez's world title. Postal busier here in the beginning of this round, but not landing very effectively, and neither has Taylor so far. Right hook misses by Taylor.
So does that short left uppercut that Postal's threw on a few occasions now. He just leans his weight left and throws that short chipping left uppercut. Really effective shot. He's caught Josh with that a couple of times. Josh looking more relaxed than he has, though, in the past couple of rounds. You know, he's moving around quite freely.
Postal trying to get that uppercut again in. Taylor has not thrown a lot of punches in this round. He's been at range on the outside, but not thrown very many. And there's a pawing jab by Victor Postal. Taylor with a nice left hand and switches to righty. Let's see.
Good body shot from Postal again. That scooping right uppercut to the body, if you want to call it, that's a great shot. It's worked for him so well tonight. It's so effective.
Taylor finally with Postal against the ropes where he's wanted to get him all night. He does land a left hand.
That's where he wants to keep him as well. You can't trade with Josh Taylor up close. He's far too good in that area. For a tall lefty, no one can trade with him up close. He's brilliant up close. But, of course, Postal's kept the distance long, and he's boxed at long range. He's not giving Josh the opportunity to fight up close.
Another big right hand downstairs by Postal. Taylor skips away from the attempted right hand by Victor Postal. So under a minute left to go here in round eight, and can Josh Taylor do enough in these remaining seconds to win this round? Half a minute left to go, and Postal continues to use the jab, and it's Taylor retreating.
There's that shot again. That's a great body shot.
Seconds remaining here in round number eight. Josh Taylor lands not only a right hook, but a left hand, and they both exchange at the end of this round. Things heating up here at the Hydro Arena.
Panda, Panda, this is.
We look back at the last round, and Victor Postal controlling the tempo with his jab, and Taylor switching right-handed. And when he does, he tends to get hit with that right to the body, which we saw him get hit with just a moment ago. And Josh Taylor landed. Oh. That was one of his best combinations of the round, with the right hook and the left hand.
15 seconds.
You got it in the tank.
You need to start going for the years.
10 seconds.
Okay, nice and neat. Nice and neat.
Second of this round, you got to stay focused.
According to Alex's unofficial scorecard, Postal edging ahead in this fight. He's had two very good rounds. It's up to Josh Taylor now to get inside and rough him up a little bit like this, and that's exactly what Taylor's trying to do here. Good body work and nice uppercut by Taylor, but Postal comes back with his own
great
uppercut.
Right hand, yeah. This is where Josh wants to keep that fight, right there up close. Beautiful body shot from Josh Taylor.
The right hook again. We're in round number nine of a scheduled 12-rounder. It has been a well-fought and highly contested affair. Victor Postal on the 34-year-old who just took a left hand from Josh Taylor. Former world champion, has only lost once in his career to Terrence Crawford, and he appears to have hurt his back. Josh Taylor, the undefeated 27-year-old, came into this fight 12-0. Lands a huge right hook and maybe hurt Victor Postal. We'll
see.
Wow,
took it so well, Postal. Took it so well, that shot.
Taylor has been more active in this round, has managed to get on the inside a little bit more. Halfway through round number nine.
What a great chin Victor Postal has.
Good right hook to the body by Taylor. Taylor again going downstairs, and that's his calling card. card, but
great body shot from Josh Taylor.
Has not been able to do it very much in this fight.
Very clever up close work from Victor Postol there. A short right uppercut followed by a left hook.
Minute left to go here in round number 9. And a better round for Josh Taylor here in the 9th round, to be sure, after 2 rounds that didn't go very well for him. Taylor with a left hand that just misses. And Taylor using the jab now, and I think that's been a big difference for him. But, oh, nice right hand by Postol.
Oh, beautiful jab from Josh Taylor, followed by a left cross and a right hook. That's much better from Josh Taylor.
This crowd excited to see Taylor erupt in what has been a very good 9th round for him for the most part.
Huge counter left hand.
Postol
brilliant
did a
shot
very
from
good
Josh
right
Taylor.
Hand, and Josh Taylor made him walk into a big counter punch, and this crowd is on its feet. And why not?
You need every round in now, okay? That's how the fight is, okay? You attack him, attack him. Once he feels comfortable, you drop back and you nail him with a shot. With a right hook.
Very exciting round of boxing, and that's the right hook. That, or a right hook that Taylor landed that was very effective.
Josh Taylor picked some really nice counter punches in that round, particularly the left cross counter. Postol overreached with the right hand. Josh Taylor came back with that left cross counter right on the money. What a shot. Both. What a chin Victor Postol has.
All right. He's doing this. You know that right hook's coming. Drop back, nail him. Right hook. Right hook. Right hook.
Okay. Intensity,
come on,
Josh.
Come on, you've got to stay on for 3 minutes of every round from now on in.
We head into the 10th round, a place Josh Taylor has not been. Victor Postol has been here a number of times. Let's see how the youngster reacts. Taylor attacking. These are the championship rounds, and Taylor may need a rally. It's hard to tell. Certainly the fight has been highly contested. Taylor using his jab effectively again, and again for momentarily switching to right-handed. Another good body shot by Taylor as he continues to go downstairs as he has in the last round or two. Both men landed some thunderous punches toward the end of round number 9. Taylor body attack, which they hoped would be there earlier, has materialized in the last round or two. And a right hand by Taylor as he attacks from the right-handed stance.
Switching up has been quite effective for Josh tonight. He switched up very well.
And even though Victor Postol has more experience in these later rounds, at age 34, will age catch up to him as this fight wears on? Taylor is having himself a very good round 10.
Yeah, good body shot from Josh Taylor as well.
And now Postol holding in that cut over the right eye that came early in the fight because of a clash of heads has opened again.
Beautiful job from Postol. Good right hand as well. Josh Taylor has to maintain control. He can't let Postol take over the last minute of this round. He's had a brilliant first 2 minutes. He has to maintain that and keep boxing smart at long range. When he's up close, let those combinations go, finished by those body shots.
Under a minute left to go here in round number 10, a round in which Taylor did get off to a blazing start. And now Postol has come back a bit. Again, the body work from Taylor as he tries to bully Victor Postol. Switching again to the right-handed stance. Postol trying to hold on the inside and Taylor not letting him do it. Fainting by Taylor. We haven't seen much of that. Left hand!
Huge
sends Postol down!
Three, four, five,
for the fourth time in his last two fights. Well, Josh Taylor had never seen the 10th round, but he liked what he saw in this fight. Yeah. When he got to the 10th round, things worked out pretty well for him.
That might just have won him the fight.
We have a couple rounds left to go,
but it certainly
helped him. Yeah. And we'll get a chance to see where that knockdown happened. There's the straight left hand that sent Victor Postol down in the 10th round.
Huge left hand counter. Huge.
This crowd has come to life, and that's an understatement. Victor Postol, the 34-year-old Ukrainian fighter, trying to stem the tide of this 27-year-old youthful Scott, who knocked him down in the last round, the first knockdown of the fight. And Taylor continuing to put the pressure on at the behest of this noisy crowd. Taylor with an uppercut that gets in. And now Victor Postol kind of holding on, it seems, to buy time.
Postol.
That was a very solid left hook.
It was, and control in the center of the ring right away.
Yeah, Taylor hasn't let him do that in the last couple of rounds.
No, he's not. Let's hope Josh hasn't taken his foot off the gas, but that was really, really impressive from Victor Postol.
Now, a reminder, the last round was undoubtedly a 10-8 round for Taylor, but remember, this had been a very, very close fight, and Postol had put a number of early rounds in the bank as well, so we'll see how things will end up if this fight goes to the scorecard. Taylor hopes to get another knockdown or a knockout, but we'll see.
Oh. Oh, brilliant combinations from Postol.
Victor Postol doing enough to keep Taylor off of him, but also leaving himself open and getting hit with the left hand by Taylor. Victor Postol is not fighting a safety first fight right now. He is going after Josh Taylor,
which is unusual for him.
Yeah, at this juncture, you would think he would be wanting to run out the clock and maybe think he can get a decision. He's going after Taylor.
He's going after him, totally out of his comfort zone.
A very exciting 11th round. A minute left to go in this stanza, and it could be up for grabs. Both men landing big power shots. There's one thing we can say for certain. This has been a well-fought and exciting fight.
And a brilliant fight to watch.
Good jab by Josh Taylor. Punctuated by that knockdown in the last round by Josh Taylor. And in this round, Taylor got off to a very good start, but Postol has come back in the second part of the round.
There's that huge left-hand counter from Josh Taylor again. He waits on Postol leading with the right hand. As soon as Postol's shoulder starts to move, Josh Taylor retracts. He lets the left hand go. He's walked Postol into that shot three or four times tonight.
There will soon be 3 minutes left in this championship fight. Will those 3 minutes decide the winner? We'll find out. A look back at round number 11. That was the big left hand that landed from Josh Taylor. Early on in the round, Taylor did extraordinarily well.
Heavy, heavy left hook counter there from Josh Taylor.
You're coming out of combination. You're exhausted, you get nailed with shots. Just stay nice and tight. 3 minutes. Out of work. You've got jab your way in, double it up. Go to body, double it up, go to head, and then start finishing your front hook. 20 seconds, okay? Intensity, just keep yourself.
Shane McGuigan telling him to double jab. Do you know, I believe, as we look at your scorecard and you have a very close fight, With Taylor now up by 3 points, that's unofficial, of course. When Taylor jabs in this fight, he is infinitely more effective. And Shane McGuigan urging him to double jab his way in.
Much more. We had then put the heavy shots in behind the jab.
We head into round number 12, the final round of this fight, and it gets chippy on the inside. Both men holding in there, but Taylor trying to work. 3 minutes left. Taylor ripping a shot down to the body and going after Victor Postol, pushing him back with a left hand. Clearly, Taylor seems the fresher of the two, although Postol, toward the end of the last round, did do some good work. Taylor has never been to this distance, but he has looked very fresh in the last two rounds. Postol's last 12-round trip, of course, against Terrence Crawford, where he lost, was down twice. He's been down once in this fight. Caught over the right eye, and Taylor, that big clash of heads.
Big clash of heads, huge.
And I think Postol got the worst of it.
Yep, he looks wobbly out. Using his feet, we've never seen him move away like this tonight. George Taylor's hunting them down now.
Using all of this ring, and Taylor trying to get on the inside to bully Postol. Again, the jab of Taylor. This young man was facing dire straits back in round 7 and 8, even headed into 9, but he has come back in the end of this fight to bully Victor Postol. We are more than halfway through this final round. Postol looking for something that might steal this round after Taylor got off to a very good start. Ian John Lewis has done a very good job of refereeing this fight, allowing the fighters to keep working.
Very, very good job. Probably the best referee in the country for me, if I'm going to be really honest. Brilliant referee, Ian John Lewis. He's led the guy's fight.
Under a minute left to go. They come down to the final seconds. The crowd on its feet. And Josh Taylor and Postol trying to land something important. A nice right hand by Postol as they battle away on the inside.
Both guys trading huge blows still to this point. Only 20 seconds left in this.
Taylor with an overhand left and Postol trying to land his right and heads banging on the inside.
Both answering each other back with huge shots.
And so it will go the distance here at the Hydro Center in Glasgow. Who will have won the chance to fight for a world title? We'll see. And so Josh Taylor, held aloft by his team, they feel he might have done enough in the final rounds to win this. There's no question that Taylor came on very strong, scored a knockdown in this fight in the last three rounds, and came on extremely strong in those last three rounds. For Victor Postol, the 34-year-old veteran, proved one important thing tonight. He is not damaged goods.
No,
he is still an upper echelon 140-pounder,
without
correct?
Without a shadow of a doubt, Al. Without a shadow of a doubt.
Fought extremely well, as did Taylor.
Great chin, great judgment at distance, beautiful techniques, some really, really good shots. We've seen him throw that, especially that scooping uppercut to the body. Lovely straight rights down the middle, real world-class fighter.
And will this decision come down to the knockdown that Josh Taylor created in this fight? It was the only knockdown in the fight. Both men had nicks over their eyes. That did not impact the final judgment of this fight. It wasn't stopped. See the McGuigans there, nervously hoping that their young charge has won this decision. And we talk about Postol. What Josh Taylor proved tonight is that he is ready to be in the upper echelon of the 140-pounders. Lots of drama being played out here in Glasgow as we await the decision of the judges. It was a fight that had ebbs and flows. In the early rounds, Postol seemed to dictate the tempo and the distance of the fight. As it went on, Josh Taylor was able to work on the inside a little bit more effectively, especially in the later rounds. For the WBC super lightweight eliminator, the winner presumably to get a world title shot against Jose Ramirez, who has a optional defense, and then in theory would face this mandatory winner, though oftentimes theory in boxing doesn't add up to reality. You can feel the tension in this arena as we await the final decision. They're looking at, obviously checking out the scorecards to make sure things are accurate.
Ladies and gentlemen, our referee Ian John Lewis will bring together both boxers. He has asked me to ask you to join him in appreciation. Both boxers in the ring. Well, ladies and gentlemen, after 12 hard-fought rounds of championship boxing, we go to our judges' score totals. Judge Victor Lachlan, 118, 110. Fernando Barbosa, 117, 110. Eddie Papo, 119, 108. All for the winner. Now the mandatory challenger for the WBC 140-pound crown.
Josh Taylor did not need to get that knockdown to win this fight. He wins by fairly comfortable margins on the judges' scorecards.
Ladies and gentlemen, please.
And he not only keeps his silver belt, but he puts himself in a position where he will challenge, or could challenge, for the WBC 140-pound